Hello everyone. In this video, we will walk you through the steps to perform an automatic 2-point pH calibration using the Knick Stratos Multi transmitter and a Memosens pH sensor. The calibration will be performed offline in a controlled environment right here in our workshop. Our connected pH sensor is a Memosens smart digital sensor. The calibration will be written and stored in the head of the sensor. These steps, however, can also be utilized when performing a calibration in the field. To perform a calibration, you will need a Stratos Multi transmitter that has been powered up with a Memosens cable connected, a Memosens pH sensor, at least two buffers with clean containers to pour them in, rinsing water, and a clean cloth to dab the sensor dry. Let's begin by pressing menu on the main screen and then enter on calibration. If access to the calibration menu is blocked via a passcode, please note that the default is 1147. Once inside the calibration menu, we will select the Memosens pH sensor that is connected to channel 1 of our transmitter. We will be conducting a calmatic or automatic calibration today, but here you can see the different options available when performing a calibration. The Stratos Multi also allows us to perform a manual calibration, a product calibration or single point standardization, adjustment of the electrode slope and zero point via data entry, and lastly, an adjustment of the internal temperature detector. We will ensure that calmatic is selected here before proceeding further. Under the number of calibration points, we will select 2 point and then move on to the selection of our buffer set. As we are performing an automatic calibration, it is very important that we have the proper buffer set selected in our Stratos Multi transmitter. This ensures automatic recognition of the buffer values as well as automatic temperature compensation during the calibration process. The Multi has numerous buffer tables stored within its software for selection by the operator. It is important to note that NIST technical is most commonly used. However, verification of your buffer values should be cross-checked against the values displayed at the bottom of the screen. A nice feature, which is also available for selection, is the ability to select a user-defined buffer table. We will select the Knick Calimat buffers and press Enter to continue. Once we are ready to perform our calibration process, we will press Enter on the Proceed button to move on to the first steps. As you can see, once the calibration process begins, the transmitter enters a hold mode, holding the output back to our control system. This is also indicated by the Nemours wrench icon in the upper left corner of our display screen. Here, we are prompted to rinse our sensor with DI water and place it in our first buffer solution. We will do so and place the sensor into the buffer 7. We want to ensure that the entire pH measuring bulb, along with the sensor's junction, are immersed in the buffer. We will stir lightly and then press the next button. After pressing next, the transmitter will begin to check the drift in the first buffer solution. You can see that the buffer value is automatically recognized. The raw pH voltage value is displayed along with the measured temperature and response time of the electrode in the buffer. Once finished in the first buffer solution, the transmitter will prompt you to again rinse the sensor and immerse it in the second buffer. We will do so and place our sensor in the buffer 4 solution. Again, stir lightly and press next to proceed. As with the first step, you can see that the transmitter automatically recognizes the second buffer value, displays the pH voltage, temperature, and response time. Once complete in the second buffer solution, our Stratos Multi now displays the specifics of our calibration record. A pH chart at the top of the screen indicates the two buffer values that were used, 4 and 7. Next, we have a timestamp of our calibration, followed by the type of calibration that was performed, as well as the specific values of our zero point and slope of our electrode. Lastly, we have the sensor face icon in the top left corner of our display, indicating the status of our calibration. Here you can see we have the opportunity to select either calibrate or adjust. Please note that only by selecting the adjust button will the data be written to the head of the sensor. Selecting calibrate here will not make adjustments to the sensor and will return you to the main calibration screen. We will select the adjust button to make the changes to our sensor and finalize the calibration process. We are now ready to go online with our measurement or disconnect our calibrated sensor for future use in the field. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos on the Stratos Multi transmitter by Knick.